COVID-19 testing has increased dramatically over the past 9 days when two women travelling from the United Kingdom and granted compassionate leave from isolation were confirmed as having it. On Tuesday, laboratories completed 9,174 tests, the highest single day of testing in New Zealand. There's no evidence of community transmission, which is at odds with what Todd Muller suggested on this program yesterday. But two things are happening, both to be expected. More people with COVID-19 are arriving in the country, hopefully to be stopped and detected at the border. And winter is giving more of us illnesses with symptoms similar to COVID-19. So let's take stock of all of this. And who better to do that than microbiologist and the one and only Dr. Siouxsie Wiles. Good morning.
Good morning.
Okay, so obviously that was quite a complex intro, but the fact is our testing has been ramped up. Is this why we're seeing more cases?
We're seeing more cases of COVID-19 because people are coming back to New Zealand, and obviously this pandemic is raging around the world, right? So, mm-hmm. It's been going from, 100,000 cases a day to now, I think the peak has been like 180,000 cases a day mm-hmm. around the world. And so as more people come home, then we see cases. The other thing the other reason why we're seeing them more now is because before the beginning of the month, we were only testing people who had symptoms. Mm-hmm. So if they had symptoms when they were in managed quarantine, then they were basically tested. And if they didn't, then they weren't left to mingle or everything. But they wouldn't have been picked up. And we do know that some people can have the virus with no symptoms. But there's no really good evidence that those people are actually infectious or very infectious at all. So
is
now what we're doing,
that they're not though.
There's been some really good studies that have looked at, taken people and then said, right, these people all tested positive mm-hmm. and then looked at the contact tracing that was done around them and said, right, which people resulted in further cases. And
right.
The really good study that has been done, there were no cases, there were about 100 of these people and there were no cases onwards from them. The problem in the literature is that, although as people are writing up these studies, is they're using this word asymptomatic to mean two different things.
Right.
So they're using it to mean people who have no symptoms, and they're using it to mean the people who have no symptoms before they develop symptoms. So we know that people with COVID-19 can spread the virus for the few days before they develop symptoms.
Right. So they're more pre-symptomatic,
yes,
aren't they?
Yes, exactly. Yeah. But there's very few people using those distinctions in the academic literature where they're writing about papers, and so lots of people are going, oh, well, that means we've got lots of people who are asymptomatic who spread the virus, which is a kind of, so it's a bit of a technical thing that is really difficult because it's kind of muddying our understanding of this.
Okay, so most people at home might not understand that, but what they do understand is that our border is our greatest defence.
Yes.
A lot of people have been saying, why don't we test people before they get on the plane or at the border? But you're supporting the government's insistence that that's not effective.
Well, again, what's the reason for testing, I guess? So New Zealanders have a right to come home.
Mm-hmm.
If we test them before they come, then we will get some information about whether they have either had the virus, because some people can still shed the virus or virus bits of dead virus after mm-hmm. they've recovered. So what would we do with those people? But if they're negative, that doesn't mean that they aren't incubating the virus or that they don't get the virus as they're transiting on their way to New Zealand.
Mm-hmm.
So the whole thing about a day three is it picks up people who got infected just before they were, they got on a plane or were coming in transit. But it also picks up these people who are asymptomatic, who don't, who probably won't pass the infection on to anyone else. The important thing is the isolation.
Mm-hmm.
The testing just gives us more information.
Sure.
It is not it's also changing slightly the management of people. So
mm-hmm.
we have two versions of isolation in New Zealand. We have the managed isolation, which is for people without symptoms and who don't test positive. And then we have quarantine, which is where you put the people who are deemed at a higher risk of transmitting the virus.
So would say new regime, it was meant to be the regime, but the new regime of testing on day 3 and day 12 has highlighted that before this came into effect,
yep.
we were letting people out without being tested. So
yep.
Nearly 2,000 people have been let out of managed isolation without any tests.
After their 14 days.
After their 14 days.
Which is the same as the 20,000 people that have come in since April.
Is there, though, some truth in Todd Muller's comments that we are at risk of reseeding the virus in the community?
It's always been a risk. So because we know that the border is our, you know, I mean, that's it, that's the line, right? And people are going to come into the country. So we've always said this is where, once we've eliminated, this is where the virus is going to come in, and we need really good, you know, standards around how people behave in that facility, in those facilities, and how they're treated and stuff, and how they manage. So we know that. One of the really important things, though, is that we also have said the reason why we want people to still go and get tested if they have symptoms, mm-hmm. is in case there are any breaches, right. that we can pick those up, that we have the contact tracing to do that. There is no evidence at the moment that that has happened. From the testing that's been done, you know, all the cases that have been picked up have been those that are in managed isolation. We really must remember that.
I know a few people who, as it gets a bit colder, are getting the sniffles, maybe they're sneezing, but they don't want to go get tested, they don't want to wait in the lines, they don't want to have that horrible swab, they don't think it's in the community. What is your advice?
So, again, we don't think it's in the community, but this is our second line of defence, right? Our first line of defence is the border. People make mistakes, things happen.
Right.
The important thing is we have that second line of defence, and that's all about ensuring that we pick up if there is anything out there. Again, there's no evidence that's there, but we have to remember we're in this for the long haul. We really, I mean, we're up at nearly, what, 10 million cases around the world?
Yes.
We are in this for the long haul, and so we need to get really, our behaviour has to be really good, right? We have to be absolutely mindful that we want to make sure that if we have the sniffles, it is just the sniffles, because unfortunately, we didn't eliminate the common cold, right, when we were in level 4. That didn't happen. We know that's back. But because those symptoms can be so similar, we just need to make sure. And that's why we're still asking people to do, you know, to keep a check of where they've been. This is something I've been saying for weeks, right? As we move down the levels, we need to keep these behaviours up because they are our second line of defence. We just need to make sure.
We do, absolutely. Thank you so much once again for your very valuable time, Dr. Siouxsie Wiles.
Yeah, we so appreciate that. That was such good messaging this morning. Thank you.
My pleasure.
Because it is, like, winter, I've got a cold.
Absolutely. And it's not for us to unilaterally determine that we don't have COVID-19.
Exactly.
Right?
Yeah. But it's also, we need to remember that the message is also still stay at home if you're unwell.
Yeah,
right?
That's right.
Don't do the things that will allow the virus, or any virus,
yeah,
to spread.
And when there are north of 9 million cases, approaching 10 million cases in the world, then of course people are going to arrive at our borders
and
with
COVID-19. And we'll see more of that.
Yeah. And we will see more of that.
Yeah.
But that's not the same as community transmission.
Yeah. And it's no reason to fear those people either. Mm-hmm. Remember, we are a safe haven, mm-hmm. and people have the right to come home.
Yeah, they do.
They do. And remember kindness, everybody.
Thanks, Susan.
That's important.